Way to mark the day. Maybe you know that there are several events today going on in Israel. There is a center, I don't know in Jerusalem what is going on. There is a central march in Tel Aviv, starting at 6 for southern Tel Aviv and marking the synagogue. So if you can stay and hang out in Tel Aviv and join the march. So my name is Jessica Nivon. I am the Resources Development Coordinator of the Coalition of Women for Peace. I am a feminist and an activist. I'm dealing with issues of conflict resolutions and transitional justice. My partners in the staff is Mayan Dak, co-coordinator, Abim Amer, and Christina
Brennan House.
She's coordinator of a special project we have related to non-violence and with advertising, which is special event, international conference on non-violence in mid of December. You can find this. You can do to join in the event in Facebook. So we the last months of the summer, the attack on Gaza were very dramatic days. The political developments and the violence were escalating, the racism against Palestinians in Israel, this pressure for unity, for being together, because we are being attacked, but all the the relationships also between Jewish and Palestinians inside Israel, the peace movement, were very much impacted by this period, and the relationships among each group, Jewish peace activists and Palestinian peace activists, a lot of tensions and conflicts and dilemmas, and we are dealing with issues in several ways. We wanted to have this women speak out, this basic feminist form of gathering together and giving testimony of personal experiences in the public space, giving legitimacy to the unique experiences of women, how conflict, war and violence impact us, how our sense of security is influenced, and we are using this form that it's used in several ways of women giving their voice in the public space that sometimes is marginalized. We wanted to do it in December. The Coalition of Women for Peace was established in the beginning of the Second Intifada by women activists and peace women organizations together. That's the reason it was called Coalition of Women for Peace. The link was called Coalition of Women for Justice. And then it's a way, but the justice, it's in the center of our vision. And along the years, now the coalition, it's an independent NGO. We deal with several programs, several issues, but I will tell you more. We have here in the panel Ruti Ferreira, photographer and social activist. Ruti will talk, she lives in Beersheba, and she will talk about women in Beersheba during the war. We have Rose Amar from Ajik, Misfit, it's an NGO in the Negev. And Rose will talk about the impact of the war on young Palestinian women in the Negev. Mayan Dak, Coalition of Women for Peace, Feminist Anti-War Efforts in Tel Aviv and Political Violence. And Hulud Hamis, writer and photographer, feminist activist, member of Ishal Ifsha. And Hulud will focus in the anti-war efforts in Haifa and the violence experience there. Then, at the end, you see Women Security Index Research, preliminary findings. We will have a short video. The Women Security Index, it's a coalition of women's organizations that decided to put a different focus on the definition of what is security. As you know, in Israel, the word security is generally related to IDF, militarism, a very narrow definition of what is national security, and a broader definition, a feminist perspective on security talks about our feeling of security and insecurity, feeling of what is our home, how much do we fear to lose our home, how much do we care about the families around, and all this. So the Human Security Index is doing this every year. So we are comparing how every year the sense of security and insecurity of women is changing. So this coalition did immediately after the war, the attack on Gaza in the summer. So you have also a page in your folder.